access into this grace by faith. Jesus' faith saved us. Our faith, believing on Him, we accept salvation. But here's what we do: we rejoice in hope. Y'all see the word hope? See, I'm going to take some time, I believe, God, to try to make us understand how big this hope is. I was studying this again yesterday. I didn't have much time to study today. He said, rejoice in hope, which means that I'm rejoicing, always expecting something. Mm-hmm. One of the biggest mistakes that we make in church, man, we put the focus on us from being saved. We put the focus on what we think about us, what people say about us, what we can do right and what we can do wrong. This Bible tells me right here, when I get access into this grace because I received Jesus, now my focus should be on my hope. The same hope that's anchored my soul under this promise. Y'all getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
This should really help you. So now I hope in the glory of God. Why am I hoping in the glory of God? I'm up under grace. It's God's ministry. So I'm hoping to see Him perform everything He promised me.
Yes.
I'm hoping to see Him perform. Are y'all seeing where I'm going with this?
Yes.
That's why this word is so powerful. So I have access into this grace by faith. Where we stand, you know, we are under grace, amen, rejoice in hope of the glory of God. But here's the next point. Let's just lay the foundation again. Remember, verse 1, we're justified by faith, right?
Mm-hmm.
That means you're good with God.
Yes.
You have peace with God right now. Doesn't matter what you did today, what you did yesterday, what you're going to do tomorrow. Your peace is not conditional on that. Your peace is conditional on what Jesus did. We got that, right? So you have peace with God, no matter what your mind tells me. Does you. Now you have access by faith into this grace. So you're up under God's grace right now. You're up under His ministry, His love, His truth, His umbrella, this awesome thing that God has done. But while we're in the grace, we should rejoice in hope. We got to remain hopeful because hope is the substance of our faith. But watch this now, of the glory of God. We're looking forward to what God's going to do. We're looking at the day and waiting for the day when He appoints the thing that's appointed to perform. But not only so, here's what I want to talk to you about. We glory in tribulation also. Watch this now. What is He saying to you? That tribulation is written in the grace. Y'all ain't talking to me here. Yeah? He said we glory in tribulation also, which means that even though I'm up under grace, I'm going to run the tribulation.
Yeah.
Jesus said tribulation will come, prepare for it. He said it is impossible that tribulation won't come, as a matter of fact. Jesus said that. So basically, this is a good teaching. I might have to do this again Sunday. While I'm rejoicing in hope of the glory of God, because I'm under grace, I know it's not about me, it's God's ministry.
Right.
So He promised me something, He's going to perform it. But while I'm rejoicing, tribulation is assigned to it. So I'm going to run into some things that I don't like. I'm going to run into some things that are going to make me look good, to make me feel good. So what He say? Not only so, but you glory in the tribulation too. So what He's saying? Even when you're in it, keep giving God praise.
Mm-hmm.
See, rejoice about. See, you know when you're maturing. I think I think some of us getting this in general. You know when you're really maturing in God, when you can glory in tribulation.
Yes,
That's true.
Because you're growing up.
Yes.
Because you understand this tribulation has a purpose. You don't say, oh, look what the devil doing. See, that's when you're a child in Christ,
yes,
or before you come to God. When you can see it and smile, or when you can see it and rejoice and shout,
yes,
or when you can see it and say hallelujah, or when you can see it and say, I still believe God, that means you're maturing.
Yes.
You don't feel good about it,
yes,
but remember, it's a word life, right? It's a word life. So now He said, we glory also in tribulation. Why? Because tribulation worketh patience.
Mm-hmm.
Patience worketh experience. And experience hope. So it takes you right back to hope. Okay? You hope in the glory of God, because you know it's coming. So when the tribulation comes, there's a process. It's going to make you patient, because tribulation, but let me tell you something, what tribulation will teach you. It'll teach you that you're not in control.
That's
true. Am I here by myself?
Yes.
If you learn nothing else from trouble
yes,
teach you that you're not in control.
Oh, yes.
When you go through enough trouble that you couldn't change, it will show you that you ain't got control of nothing.
That's
y'all
right.
Ain't talk back to me.
That's true.
It'll teach you to take your hands off and be patient.
That's right.
And wait till God changes it.
That's true.
Y'all ain't talk to me. Yeah, I feel good here. I feel like preaching.
Right.
Am I preaching good here?
Yes.
So what tribulation is trying to get us to quiet our souls.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Just get us to rest and trust God. So the more we don't trust, the more trouble we see.
Yes.
See, God's a master builder. He knows exactly who you are, and He knows exactly what it's going to take to get you.
Yes. That's true, that's
so
true.
So if he know that he birthed you for a certain destiny that requires you to be hard at it, you can see a little bit more tribulation than most
that's
people.
That's right, here we come.
Y'all know I'm going to talk to me.
Go ahead, so.
And all the Negroes should say amen.
Amen.
Because hard at it is what we are, amen.
That's true.
So we need to understand that in this grace plan, I'm going to have to do this again Sunday for a little bit of it. In this grace plan, this is not helping you.
Yes.
In this grace plan, tribulation is in it. That's what it's telling you. But tribulation is not for you to feel sorry. Mm-hmm. See, in the beginning, as you mature, you'll cry about stuff. I tell you, ain't much can happen to upset me today, man. And I'm not boasting. It's because I've been through so much pain. I've seen so much disappointments. I've seen too much betrayals. Y'all ain't talking back to me. I've seen so many attacks. That ain't much to upset me today. No matter what it is, my response will be the same thing. This is the Lord's doing. There, my wife right there, I'm telling you, my response will be the same thing. I'm going to go to the Word, and I'm going to go to sleep. Mm-hmm. Now, the thing that will keep me up at night is when I get attacked by some spirits, and now the Lord has showed me my power. It might take two times to speak to them, but they're going to leave my room.
Oh, yes.
Y'all ain't talking back to me. I wish I could just drop that on some of y'all. If you understand the power that you have, and that's how God trains you in your own house, when them devils attack your bed, don't attack your mate. Attack the devil.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Y'all not gonna talk to me. Because when that anger show up, that's the devil. When that frustration show up, that's the devil. When that anxiety shows up, y'all ain't talking back to my fruits and
grip. Go ahead.
That's the devil. Yes. So instead of feeding the devil, attack him.
That's true.
You got the Holy Spirit living in you. You up under the blood of Jesus. Tell the devil, get a child. Most of the times, you will see that he runs right away. But when he comes on a serious attack, you might have to tell him a second time.
Yep.
Y'all not going to talk to me. Okay. And can I take a sidebar here? Lest I fool you like we do people in church. When these things happen, the last thing you want to do is talk to the devil. Mm-hmm. You don't have no energy to do it. That's how you feel.
Yeah.
Because that's how, come on now. I let this all the time, you see? See, it's good to know this, to know you ain't different from nobody else. Because that pressure comes on you, and you become anxious, and everything gets on your nerve. You know what I mean? Y'all ain't talking to me.
Go ahead, sir.
Am I here by myself?
No.
Everything gets on your nerve. If somebody coughs, it gets on your nerve.
Yes.
You look at the hair, it gets on your nerve. It's too long, it's too short. Y'all ain't talking to people. That's what anxiety will do to you.
Yeah.
You'll feel like you make your toes rub together, it claws your skin. Y'all ain't talking to me.
Yeah.
Can we talk about this?
Oh, yes.
If you put your foot on top of one another, you feel like you're on a grate or something like that, you see, it feels so dry, that's anxiety. The TV too loud or too low. It ain't never the right volume.
Oh, yes.
Because what happens is, when the Spirit attacks you, he's trying to get you uncomfortable. His biggest purpose is to bring strife.
Wow.
Right. Because eventually, somebody in the house will say something.
Yeah.
And right now, you don't really hear nobody, you don't need nobody say nothing to you, amen? Let me get off of that, because I think y'all can have that kind of stuff. But this is for people who really live in the spiritual life.
Yes.
And what I want to tell you is, mature with me tonight. You have the power to speak to that thing, even though you don't feel like it. And sometimes you got to fight yourself through to speak to it.
Yes, you do. Yeah.
Sometimes you got to get out of the bed, because laying there, you'll never have the power to do it. You have to get out of bed and stand out of bed and say, devil, I see you. You will not cause no disruption in my house. I command you out of this house right now.
Yes.
Yep. See, that don't make no sense, but it works.
Mm-hmm.
You know why we think it won't work? Because we don't think we qualify. I am not no more qualified than you. Every man is given a measure of faith. I might have been through a little more hell than most of y'all, because y'all still young. Your day coming. Hold on, amen. But I will save you right now. If you have the Holy Spirit dwelling in you, you are a child of God and you have that power. You have the power to control your environment.
Amen.
You have the power to keep strife on your environment. Instead of talking to the person, talk to the devil.
Yeah.
I am constantly talking to hatred and frustration and anger and criticism. Because if you're in a relationship, these things are the ones you have to battle all the time.
Yes, God.
Maybe not in your relationship. I'm just talking for me, amen. But if you want to be honest, you know that that's what gets you all the time. You get the anxiety kicks in, and then frustration comes, and then anger comes, and then now all of a sudden you don't think you hate them, but your behaviors towards hatred, No, because your thought said, I'm going to straighten this thing out, and I can't